Okay, good morning everyone, it's Riccardo Taglia speaking. It's very glad to be here to present my joint work with Professor Ugo De Liguoro, both of us from University of Turin. Today we will talk about our confluence and factorization result for computational lambda calculus. What we will present today is part of a wider ongoing research topic stemming from Moji computational monad and computational lambda calculus, the intuition behind encapsulate non-functional part of programming languages in the meta language that is lambda calculus. Well, we will shape our computational lambda calculus via Wolders' definition of computational monads, and we'll exploit the parametricity behind computational monad. Well, what we will talk today is the syntax part, but there is a whole branch about semantics. We studied the intersection type assignment system, Alabar and design, improving the subject convertibility, for example, and we provided two models, fifth model and the inverse limit model, relating them. What we will talk today is computational lambda calculus. The aim is prove confluence and factorization in the untyped case. So let's start with the definition by Wolder computational monad that is a triple. A triple where the first element T is a type constructor that leads us to move from values to computations, where computations are programs with effects built over values. This triple is equipped with other two polymorphic operators, unit and bind. Well, unit is a lifting or better coercion of values to computation, to their trivial computation. And the bind operator takes input a computation, a function from values to computation, giving back a computation. These two operators should be should follow three basic actions quickly: the functional application, the identity law, and a sort of associativity. Keep in mind these three actions because we will see them again while talking about our reduction relation. Well, seems quite nonsense to speak about untyped computational lambda calculus where both Moji's and Wolder's definition of monads involves a type constructor. As inspired by Scott in the 80s, much of untyped lambda calculus can be seen as a typed lambda calculus with just one type. The type that is the retractor of the space function, of the space of any function. In this case, semantically, we stated the existence of the call by value reflexive object because we wanted to talk about call by value. But if we wanted to talk about call by name, in the case of call by name, we have to semantically provide the existence of such a type of solution. So this two sorts between values and computation is mirrored in our syntax. In fact, we have values that are variables and abstractions and computation that are lifted values and what is constructed by the bind operator. Supposing that each variable has type B of values, it's easy to see that each variable values is type D and each computations is type TD. So here we are to our reduction relation that is built over computation, just in the tier of the computation, and it is obtained by orienting. What?
Ricardo, sorry about interrupting, but some people is complaining about the audio conditions. Might you try the computer microphone to see whether it is better?
Ah, it's strange because okay. Generally this is better. Okay, let's try.
Okay, only to try whether it works better.
But it's better now.
Try with the computer microphone and then we decide whether we choose this option or the other option, okay? You can
okay,
continue.
Okay, I'm trying to, I'm without my... Now it's better. I don't think so.
Okay, yes, it works. Yes, try that way, all right? Sorry about that.
Okay, now if now it's better, otherwise I can fix the situation, maybe.
It's okay, continue, please.
Okay, thank you, sorry for that. Anyway, I was talking about our reduction relation that is obtained by orienting the three axioms we saw before. The substitution is defined as always. We can add also the extensionality rule. Now that we have our calculus, syntax, and the reduction relation, we can compare our calculus to Modi's original one, where there is the LETCO structure, but in our case, the LETCO structure is just a syntactic sugar in terms of bind and unit. And also, we can see the bind operator as a postfix functional application, but there is no primitive functional application, but we can retrieve them by means of these translations. Also, we can retrieve the ordinary Plotkin Kolbe-Velin reduction in this way. Well, not only the Modi's calculus is very natural to compare with ours, but thanks to one of our reviewers, also the Schaffring calculus by Carraro and Guerrieri, for example, is very close to ours. Schaffring calculus is an extension of Kolbe-Velin lambda calculus with two additional reduction steps, sigma 1 and sigma 3. Sigma 1 is eaten in our calculus, but sigma 3 is very similar to us, to our us reduction. But in our case, we allow it, in fact, it can be easily translated in our calculus, but we perform us reduction just in case B is an abstraction, not a variable. We can overcome it just talking about practical values. Anyway, we can stop the comparison just to syntactic level. There are a lot of nuances that link our calculus to Schaffring calculus. For example, the confluence proof will be similar, and also the reasoning about approximant and solvability. So, coming back to our comparison with Modi's original calculus, we proved that there is a translation from Modi's calculus to ours, preserving reduction, but the converse preserves just the convertibility relation. This means that we need another confluence proof for our calculus. Since Makoto Mana 2 years ago proved the confluence of Modi's computational lambda calculus by using his tool Polysol by checking critical pairs. So now finally we can embark in the proof of confluence of our calculus, but it's not very easy since us reduction may overlap with itself and with the others. With the other reduction steps. So we split the proof in three parts, proving the confluence separately by B plus B beta plus id and us separately, and in the end, eventually, combining by means of a commutativity lemma. This strategy was adopted also, as cited before, by Carraro and Guerrieri, but also by Riola and others, talking about Kolbe-Nick calculi with LETCO structure. So let's talk about the confluence of the first section, the reduction made just by data and id. We will just extend the Takahashi method for proving confluence of beta reduction, but adding two more rules, this red one, in order to deal with the unit operator. So the lifting and the ID reduction. So by means a substitutive dilemma of this parallel reduction, we can prove that this parallel reduction is exactly in the middle between the reduction and is reflexive transitive closure. Then we will prove that the triangle property is satisfied by this parallel reduction. This implies the diamond property. And so in the end, we will prove that this reduction is confluent. When it comes with us confluence, eventually we will invoke the Newman lemma. So we will prove that the us reduction is weakly Church-Rosser, whose definition is depicted in this diagram. And also we have to prove the strongly normalizing property for us reduction. We recall that an abstract reduction system is strongly normalizing if there is no infinite reduction path starting from any given term. In our case, having given computation. I'd like to give a glimpse of our proof of strongly normalizing property for us reduction, since very, very similar to propositional logic, elementary propositional logic, in which every formula has a principal connective, and we can effectively compute which is the principal connective. Also in our calculus, we can find a principal bind operator. And thanks to that, depict our terms like trees. Like trees where the root is this principal bind operator. So decorating each occurrence in the term of the bind operator, we can notice that while performing the us reduction, there is a clockwise movement inside the tree. Defining another weight relation left to, we can notice that this clockwise movement are finite, since every term is finite. So in the end, we reach that us reduction is strongly normalizing. So combining strongly normalizing with weak Church-Rosser property, we have the Church-Rosser property for us reduction. Now we have to combine these two confluence results, and we will do that proving that the two reductions are they commute. We will do that proving a stronger property, saying that beta C plus id and us actually strongly commute. So summarizing what we did so far, we proved that by Takahashi method, extended Takahashi method, the confluence of beta C plus id, then we proved the confluence of us by means of Newman lemma. We combine this result by means of the commutative dilemma, and so we have the confluence of this of our calculus. Here we are in the second result of our short paper, that is the factorization result. We remember that abstract reduction system factorized via two class of reduction steps if given any finite reduction path from M to N, it's always possible to find L, a weakness of the property of factorization, such that we can rearrange the reduction path in the way that the first part before L is made performing just the first class of reduction steps, and the second part belongs to the latter class. Here we are an example in our calculus of two reductions stemming from the same term M. What we want to perform, what we want to have by factorization result is a sort, the first part should be a sort of leftmost, outermost reduction. We want to perform always a reduction like this one. We reach this this proof by means of the technique showed by Accattoli and others in their work factorization essentially because of two strengths. The first one is we don't split reduction steps into this joint class and also dividing the step, the reduction step. But we want to divide the two class according to where the reduction is performed. So we will split our context into essential that are included in essential context. And essential context does say that the reduction should be performed inside the leftmost part of the term. In addition, there is another technique that we spoiled that is present in Accattoli and others' work, and there is the use of the a parallel reduction of the whole calculus, but that is indexed. This is because of the parallel reduction of the whole calculus doesn't satisfy the Diamond property. So to prove the substitutivity lemma, the substitutivity property, we will use this index in the refined parallel reduction. In addition, we will use a parallel reduction also built over inessential steps. Well, using these two auxiliary parallel reduction, we will prove the final proposition stating that our abstract algebraic reduction system is a macrostep system with respect to these two parallel reduction. But combining this result with our construction, we obtain the factorization result. Each finite sequence can be rearranged, pruning a prefix of essential steps and POXFIS in essential steps. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. So are there any questions or remarks? Anyone wants to say something? So I'd like to ask about this calculus, is it new? No, it's not new, right? So
yeah, it's quite new. It stems from Moji computational lambda calculus, but it's quite easier. Moji's calculus presents the late constructor. There is a difference. This difference between values and computations, and also there are several rewriting rules. Ours is just three.
Okay.
Rewriting rules.
Moji's calculus. It was known to be confluent or not?
Ours.
Moji's.
Ah, yes, Moji's calculus is confluent. It is provided 2 years ago by Makoto Amano.
Ah, so it's recent also, okay.
Yes, before it was supposed as folklore that it is a confluent, but it was proved by Makoto Amano using his tool Polysol.
Okay. I was surprised that this is a new result, but okay. Great. So are there other questions?
I have yes, it's not really a question, it's a proposal, something would be interested for the factorization. You mentioned a method that with a work with Beniamino, with Accattoli and Guerrieri, and in fact we have a follow-up of that. to prove a factorization similarly to confluence, or to modularize a bit like is in the Hindley-Rosen technique. Mm-hmm. And we do that for the shuffling, for example. For the shuffling calculus, we have a very, very...
Yeah, it is done in factorized factorization. It's unpublished. So,
yes, because I would be interested if it would
some
be...
Some days ago.
Okay. Because I wanted to ask, if, I would be interested to know if you can apply, because in the shuffling, the proof is several pages, and we can do very, very compactly in reality.
Mm, okay. Well, there are a lot of similarities between our calculus and shuffling. Even if the morality behind it is different, one is supposed to mimic the linear logic. Our wants to talk about effects, but this sigma tree reduction step connect these two. As I think it's worth to investigate about this connection. Also comparing the proofs. Yes, you are completely right. For sure.
Maybe we can discuss on that if you're interested, because I would be interested.
Ah, okay. I'm very glad for that. Whenever.
Thank you.
No, thank you too.
Okay. So are there other questions or remarks? If not, let's thank you again. And